I believe we are good to go. Sure are. Cool. Really was surreal getting to the point of the Discord where it would warn me before doing an at everyone. Like, oh, we have that many people in there now. Ooh. 29th of October. In a couple of days, I'm going to do a proper Halloween medley extravaganza type deal. That'll be fun. But for now, it's just another shuffler. Because I think that'll be good. Now, login authentication failed? For real? Valid password or permission scopes. Okay. Well, is that indeed a problem? Let me check. I think so. I think that's a problem. Let me do the normal thing of turning it off and on again, just to see if that catches. No, it doesn't. Oh boy. All right, what do I do? I missed the part where I've just got to think back to what the video tutorial is here. Crowd shuffler. Okay. Crowd shuffler. Yep. Let's get some music going. Acquiring an OAuth token, yes. Okay. Okay. I'm gonna go through this process again. Okay. So it's this authentication process that I got to go through again. So we got a... Yep, so I've got Dale Bastion ROM Shuffler. Enter that. The OAuth. Oh, I wish that was extended. That'd be nice. Click create. Here we go. Yes. Yes. To your client ID from step 6. OAuth redirect URLs field. Oh. Oh, yeah, that's what that is, yep. Click create, which I already have done. Manage, copy the value in the client ID field, yep. And we get to that. To your client ID. Then enter the following scopes in the scopes field. Yep. Copy that. I think we're getting close. I think I figured it out. We want this one. Yeah. And then we want to open with, edit with. Yep. Yeah, go ahead and install that now. Shouldn't take too long. I think we're nearly there. Yep. Okay. And that should be fine, right? We're about to find out. I believe it's fine. I believe we're good. Okay. Moment of truth. Monster High, Ghoul Spirit. Let's go. You can't see it. No, you can. The audio is very much there, which is good. And I've realized the audio real loud. I'm going to go with 10. Yep. And if I need to make it softer, then I will. All right, Monster High. It was a different Monster High game that kicked off the very first Shuffler. Very interesting that I get all manner. Okay, werewolf, mummy, vampire, zombie, and a mashup. I appreciate that there's a mashup. I'll go zombie. That's fine. Not nearly hideous enough, but I'll take it. I appreciate being able to see it from the back. We'll go with that. And then clothes. Sure. Random name. Nessie. Zeusette. Tarantuletta. Stonette. GB. Let's go with GB. Congratulations. You are now enrolled at Monster High. Pick up your ID. To grab your ID, move closer to the ID dispenser using the... Great job! Now it's highlighted, so press A or tap it with the stylus, which I've just done. It is so soft, the music. Let's see if I could fix that. Still super soft, but you know. When you tap on an object, you can interact with a window opens. Check out your student ID in the menu. What do we got in here? Only limited to 8. It's just like Resident Evil. Okay, cool. So I could just click on it to see what it actually is. We got a ghoul meter? That's huge. Look, it's the headless headmistress Bloodgood. She looks like she has something to say. I better go hear it. Okay, still gotta navigate with the D-pad. I can't put and click on everything. Alright, there she is. We gotta tap her with the stylus. Oh, okay. Bit of persona. Let's go. Ghoul meter is a measure of popularity. I see.
Can I help you with something, miss?
Okay. Welcome to Monster High. Okay. I am Headmistress Bloodgood and you are here to learn. Okay. Is that understood? Curb that attitude. It will not be tolerated. Okay. Speaking of which, I have assigned you to a guide to help you get started. Situated. Okay. Her name is Draculaura. She will meet you outside my office. Now get going. Okay. current mission is a ghoulish guide. Meet Jack Laura in the second floor hallway. I will accept. So this is like Bully on the DS, basically. Visit Monster High Overnova. See what you might have missed along the way. Thank you, Josh. This is Monster High Ghoul Spirit. It's a play on the word school spirit. Well, it's two words. And I hope you're doing well. Open your map, touch the menu, and then touch the map icon. And there it is. It's the map. It's a coffin-shaped school. I think that's genius. Very good. Alright. Back to the overworld. Absolututely not. Still leads you to the second floor hallway. Touch the door to leave the office. I am a zombie named, I think, Juby? I think? Hang on. Oh, I might be thinking of Juby, our mate. But let me, can I confirm? Apparently not. Not just yet. Hopefully it'll show my name again shortly. Not with that spelling, unfortunately. But it was one of the it was...
You see Cleo's newest charm bracelet to die for?
So I've heard.
Hey there.
I knew the new girl. Fantastic. Stale bashed him. I did bash him. Hello, Sonny. I'm Draculaura. It is a pleasure to meet you.
Okay.
I don't need any babysitting.
Why does he stick through my heart?
You don't have to be so batty. I'm only trying to give you a hand. Your next stop is your locker. I'll show you, even though you don't deserve the kindness.
Newest charm bracelet to die for.
This is my character right here. Hope you're doing well, Sonny. I'm fitting right in here at Monster High. Subtitle, Ghoul Spirit. I'm not controlling this. Eating some soup?
Did you
Hi, also.
Charm bracelet to die for?
It's carbonated soup. But much less healthy. Yes. Got a new desk, finally have time to set it up. Excellent. I'm glad to... American chemical soup, that's right. Yeah, alright, good luck with that, Josh. Honored to be your second screen activity while you... do that. Involves unplugging and redoing my study. Okay, that's doubly huge. Good luck with it all. Welcome to your locker, your home away from home, as you walk the halls of Monster High. Here you can store items, see your achievements, decorate, and more. Third screen, that's a good point. Access the different shelves by tapping on the corresponding locker object. Close your locker by tapping back. Okay. Well, of course I'm gonna ghoulify. Oh. My DS is much too retro for that. Your outfit has changed! Oh, okay. I guess I only have two. Where can I just see what name I gave my silly character? That'd be nice. Oh, here we go. Report card. GB. I was close. Not Juby. GB. GB. I knew it was JB because I looked at it and was like, GB Hi-Fi? I've been there. Oh, and I get stickers, apparently. I'm going to put that. Then I'm going to... I need a face. Yeah, that'll do. Very good. Just a Bieber? Correct. He goes to Monster High. Still. Okay, am I able to rotate these? No. No, just got to drag it with the stylus. Okay. A Batty Boo. And, Lightning Bolt. Frankenstein, presumably. Yes, that will be my locker door. Thank you. Looks like you have an incoming text message on your eye coffin. Sure. To open your eye coffin, touch the coffin. Great ringtone. I am a zombie, but... Oh, no, of course. It's a werewolf howl, because a werewolf is calling me. Meet me in the ghoul's bathroom. Okay. I accept. Yes, the audio is very soft. It always is for DS games. just FYI. We did play one Monster High game before, and it was something like a roller rink, roller derby racing game. Quite funny. Alright, so that's the library. Oh, well, that's the glowing door, so maybe I should go through there. I think the map was kind of... Oh, I completed the episode! Hooray for me. Have I got to bust down all the cubicle doors? No. Just gotta say hi. Would you like to activate my episode? I would. Hmm. The new biology teacher doesn't speak zombie, consequently could not understand me in class. I got kicked out for mumbling. My grades cannot slip. If you want to do anything, could you help me? I mean, I am also a zombie, so I don't know how, but okay. Why would I say no to a quest? Great. First of all, would you please find Frankie in the library and get a copy of the notes from today's class and then bring them to me? Okay. I feel like you just played and enjoyed Bratz game before as well. This reminds me of that franchise of stuff. And Barbie proceeding. Yes. A Bratz game? Yes, I did. And it was pretty much the same premise. You are absolutely correct. Bratz the movie, the game. I remember now. And Gay Boy George, friend of the show, took pains to tell me that no, it's not the live action movie. It is an animated movie called Bratz the movie. Big difference. Monster High is huge now. Still? That's cool. I figured Descendants had taken over or something. I don't know. I'm not chatting to women and girls of a certain age. Not still. Bigger than it ever was. Wow. Damn. I mean, I have like girls in my family who are old enough to know about it and be fans of it. I should just ask them. Bratz Rock Angels album, fucking excellent album. I don't care what anyone says. Wow, Josh, I would not have thought you'd come into interaction with that, but fair enough. Be sure to support the Monster High Swim Team at the next meet. Something about the sports team. Again, sorry, DS audio is very soft. You couldn't hear it, neither could I. Don't worry about it. Can I ring the bell by tapping it? Apparently not. I like this fixed camera angle, movement with D-pad, and tap things to interact with it system. It's good. Seagull from Family Guy going, haha, wow. Another Optimus reference. Like, I know what Family Guy is. I don't recall the seagull bit. Where am I going? Do tell. Ghoul's bathroom. Okay. Where would that be? Maybe it was on the first floor all along. Let's find out. Have they followed the girls to Monster College and then Monster Suburbia? Have they gotten that far? I know they've done live action Monster High. No, that's my locker. I've already been there. It must be in here. Must be in the creepeteria. I may be mixing references. That is possible. I'll let you unspool that. Spacebar is more fucked on laptop? Oh dear. You got two fucky spacebars? That's much too bad. Oh, no, or is it just the one, but it's gotten even more fucked than the last time you updated us about it? That's too bad. You need that thing. Ah, hello.
Did you see Cleo's newest charm bracelet? To die for?
She has mentioned this many times. I'm in serious trouble. I'm totally into Claude, and I think a head-to-toe makeover is in order. Can you help me get it all done before he sees me tonight? Sure.
Monsters!
I need to get my hair, makeup, and dress all done before Claude's practice. I totally left my makeup kit at the pool in my locker. Go to the pool and get it for me.
Okay.
Did you see Cleo's newest charm bracelet? To die for?
Could you have recorded more than one line for this character? I just feel like that would have been good.
About trying to study Danunda next semester.
Oof. Oof. Okay. Give me a second. That's the scariest thing I've heard yet.
And I was like, she's a beauty. Hey, Ghoul.
I made a whopper of a mistake. Crikey. I just realized I have to finish my mad science project. Yeah, some of us say me instead of my. Yeah. It's not unheard of. And have tryouts for Ghoul's Screech Volleyball today. Not to mention, I have a big meet tonight. Can you help me, mate? Good. Anya. Talk to the headmistress for me. I'm so scared I won't get me homework done in time for tryouts and the meet tonight. Mary Poppins. Can you give her this note asking for an extension? Yeah, sure. Will there be, like, conflict in terms of... I say me, but I don't know where the jesting my fellow Aussies begins and my actual speech end. Yeah. Nah, that's fair enough. I'm leaving her hanging in the girls' bathroom. Find Claudine in study hall ASAP. Well, which is it? It's either in the bathroom or the study how? I'm just doing the typical RPG thing of accepting every quest. Where's me bloody keys? Yeah, no, that's true. I do it ironically sometimes also. I have a job where I have to transcribe a lot of like verbatim what ordinary people are saying. And you get a few me's in there and meselfs. There's a bit of that. I just feel like I'm not finding. Maybe you're in the janitor's closet. Maybe there's a secret. Use? Yeah, a lot of use. Lot of use. Spelled exactly like that as well. I mean, it's just the Macquarie Dictionary spellings. I'm not giving away any trade secrets. Yeah, I've been to the Belfry. The Belfry's a dead end. It'd be nice if there were, like, I don't know, an evil zombie or two. That'd be cool. Bit of combat. That's what makes a good video game. I think you'll find. Home ick. Not bad. I'm just marveling at all the puns right now. Oh, hello. Yet another quest?
Don't forget, parent creature conferences are due to start next week.
Kinder Grubber. Home and Hearth. Home ick. You look ready to fall in love with cooking. Why, yes. You are on my list, dearie. Cook or be cooked?
A doily and good manners makes any home better.
The mighty grilled squish sandwich. Use the stovetop, put your heart and soul into it. If you have to bang me, blow into a mic.
Yes, I blog. Who doesn't?
Did she just tell me she blogs? Okay. All right. Cut down. Cut left. Oh, I see. Cut right. Stir. Cut right. Cut down. Cut up. Cut left. Stir. And now you've made a sandwich. What do you think of that?
Of course I blog. Who doesn't?
Smells heavenly, huh? Yes. Perfect for fattening up children of all ages. So I can then eat the children, yes! If it tastes as good as it looks, we should be in business.
Of course I blog. Who doesn't?
Can I do that again?
Something smells good.
It's all about the freshness of the ingredients. A fresh garden snake salad. Let's go. It doesn't appear like there's any kind of time, units of time elapsing in this game. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do everything. It's not a bully situation, Rockstar bully situation. Cut up. Cut left. Cut right. Cut down. Cut up. Cut down. Stir. Cut right. Cut down. Stir. A grade, baby. I keep thinking like, well, it's not an S grade, but it'll do. But it's like, wait a minute. I'm in an actual academic context. There is no such thing as an S grade. Silly me.
Something smells good.
You continue to throw yourself into your meals. I'm sure they will all be delicious.
Don't
yes.
Forget, parent creature conferences are due to start next week.
But do you blog or not? All right. What do you want me to go? Let's see. Reacher's Lounge. Is there a third floor I should be going to? Let's have a look at the map. Home Ick, yeah. And there's me. Okay. Is it just in a whole other building or something? Or am I just going to Home Ick and then and that has to be finished before anything else? Maybe. Maybe. Okay. Time for our third cook. Vegan vampire vegetable stir fry. What makes a vampire then if it's vegan? I wonder. I am sorry to all the children who played this game and got a very unrealistic idea of what would constitute a meal in their first steps to adulthood.
Of course I blog.
They're just cutting up and down and in orthogonal directions and wondering why it's not a bowl of nutritious stir fries not forming in front of them.
My dear.
That's the biting spirit. Old Belgian delicacy, just like you. Hey now!
Parent creature conferences are due to start next week.
Rather inappropriate. Am I even Belgian? Those are well presented tentacles, I like that. B grade, well, I'll take it. I don't know why that last spin didn't take. But apparently I gotta do it again. For Miss Mummy Blogger over there. Just gonna take any original recipes and trademark it before I'm even old enough to realize that I'm being exploited. Wonderful technique, child.
What can I do for you?
Excellent.
Of course I blog. Who doesn't?
Okay. Final dish of the class. Man, they got it. They're getting a lot done. Like the one class.
Of course I blog. Who doesn't?
In high school, I rarely had a class that was longer than an hour. I guess that's just how they roll at Monster High. Eyeballs, beautiful touch. I do like the flash, Macromedia flash aesthetic going on here. I had double periods. That was 100 minutes. True. Home Ec 5 may well have been a double period.
Don't forget, parent creature conferences.
You'll climb the mountain of taste.
Don't forget.
Thank fuck. Sorry, miss.
To start next week.
I mean, Struth. Stone the crows. Yeah, I keep going to my phone when I mean to look for the map. Okay. Where to? Nowhere, apparently. Okay. So apparently. We're about to get an ad break. Okay. I'm going to snooze it because I'm sure Frank has got a pick brewing. And who am I to deny them? Also, a startup sound. A beautiful one. Go in the Crypteria. Seems like a fine place to park ourselves.
I'm suddenly feeling chaotic neutral.
Good. Do that. Oh, they got a guillotine right here. Excellent. Very forward thinking. The total absence of people is disconcerting. Oop. Ah, of course. Who is I to think that anything else would get picked under Frank's steady hand? All right. We've been doing steadily better every time we come back. We've made it to a boss encounter. I feel like we can do it. Oh boy. Yeah. Missiles are so OP. There's an NES version of this too? Excellent. I might have to play it. I assume you yourself have played it on your little launch box, doohickey. I trust that was fun. And largely the same. Into the depths, Red October. Red October, no! I'm planning to, I only just noticed it. Oh, very good, very good. Do keep us informed. Okay. Okay. Alright. We're mostly playing racing games. That's cool. I like picking a theme also when it comes to that sort of thing. Dang, I'm out of missiles. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. I got my number. Alright. Nope. Okay. Oh, lordy. Okay, but we got an extra life. That's good. Retro game-wise, I've been playing a bit of Donald Duck's Lucky Dime Caper. Well, sorry, it's called Lucky Dime Caper starring Donald Duck. Which made me nostalgic for a time when games weren't titled with the brand first, you know? Imagine. I like that the ships in this appear to work under the same rules that I do. They have a limited number of missiles and things. Almost to give you the same as what the multiplayer experience would be like. I like that. Oh, I can just crash into guys. That's fun. Alright. Oh boy. Aircraft's taking off. Oh boy. Oh, I'm doomed. I'm fucking doomed. Oh, no I'm not! But they took out my missile, my repair upgrade. So I am boned. But I did make it to the boss. That's fun. That's nice. Or maybe it'll recharge my health when I go to the next boss. That'd be fun. It was a narrow escape. Right in the spirit of the movie, I assume. Yeah, the absolute deafening silence on this is as disconcerting as ever. I think I wasted my missiles. I really did. Also, what the fuck is this thing? Game over, Red October! And now it's time for an ad break. Perfect timing, really. Well, sorry. Ad break in like a minute. Yes, the games. I don't know why the games. Well, I gotta hit start, I believe. Still haven't cracked the top 8. Tony, I'm coming for you. The famous Soviet Oceanic Technodrome, of course. As seen in Sir Billy, I think. Or was that a dream? We can make real everything we dream, comrade. Okay, I'm gonna hold off on that health boost. Hello. And yeah, there we go. And then we double back. But it's destroyed. Great. Oh well, I wouldn't have had use for it anyway. So I bet that's a multiplayer technique, you know, to shoot down the power-ups that your enemy might get. Hey, not yet. Not yet. Yeah, it's got my number and it's got cover fire. And at some point, someone found some missiles. Deeply annoying. Game, what do you want me to do there, huh? Alright, well, we got an extra life, that's fun. More missiles. Alright. Okay. Yeah, let's keep going down this way. It's a dead end, but we might find something useful. Oh my god, come on! That's happened to me before, I think. Alright, oh! I think I got him. I think I was expecting, before I ever played this, just something a little more tactical, let's say? I don't know what that would have looked like. I'm sure a game like that could be described in that fashion exists. But this is not that game. And good, I say. Yeah, there's some submarine simulators out there. Submarine warfare simulators. Alright. Alright. There we go. Now we gotta book it. Or do we? Yes. Yes. Got him! Alright. And an extra life to boot. Very nice, very nice. And I see you coming. And you're dead, I'm not. So it shall be. More missiles, thank you. I don't know what these are, though. Oh, that's right, I have the translucent ability. Which I think is the select button, if I'm not mistaken. So that might have helped when I was trying to make my way through impossible odds. Yes. I remember only learning that last zone. This is it. Yep, perfect. So I could just make a break for it. Excellent. Excellent. What is that high-pitched beeping? Oh, I'll tell you what. Now we're gaming. That's right. That's right. Hell yes. Okay. I'm not gonna bother with that thing up above me. Because I think that's enemies sitting on the surface. That's bait, one might say. And this is where I got dropped last time. So it would be very funny if you swapped a game right now. Causing me to make net zero progress. Okay. But let's see how we go. Regardless. Oh, hello. Rough. Like, I got jammed on terrain, and then they just pelted me with missiles. Okay. Damn, should've waited on that. Oh well. Alright. Time to make a break for it. Just great sounds all around. Woo! Okay. Alright. Boink! No. Boink! There we go. This game is kinda good. Kinda good. Emphasis on kinda. It's beatable. Oh, I can still get... I absolutely can still get hurt. Maybe it's just invisible to certain enemies? I don't know. Anyway, cool. Won that standoff. Shouldn't have come for me over a health upgrade. Idiot. Got him. Am I right in thinking it makes me invisible to the enemy? Or is it doing, like, maybe the opposite? I'm gonna have to look that up. I'm talking a little too far from the mic, I apologize. Alright, here we go. We're in a good spot for the boss now. This is good. This kind of prevents missile tracking, that's a good point. Yeah, you're right, I think. 100%. Frank, you are dead on. Alright. Ow. Off. I think that would improve this game, is if you heard very human pained noises as you swam around in your little submarine. Preferably the voice of Sean Connery. Ooh. Ow. Just heavily pixelated, of course. Buddy? That's why they call me Red October, bitch!
Welcome to Jurassic Park.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
Level 2!
Listen to this! How exciting! Level 2 of Hunt for Red October. Who would have thought? And an extra life, which we badly need after all that. Yeah. Time for Hop. I forget what I was doing in Hop. I know I'm James Marsden, I remember that much. Okay, I gotta clean up.
These'll make you feel better, and they're delicious too!
That's how he sounds, right? Who knows who voiced him? Oh. I completely ignored what he was saying. They're pick-upable, they're not enemies. Really, this just reminds me of that Sonic the Hedgehog 3 is coming out. And as a fan of resoundingly average video game adaptations, I can't wait. And the delayed retirement of Jim Carrey. What do we do with this thing? Twin stick shooter starring James Marsden. Just impeccable. Is that a key to the next area? I believe it is.
A fuse? So where's the fuse box?
Indeed. Russell Brand Rabbit, where is it? Okay. Yes, sir, I have played one of these before. Hey, Hopline Miami, am I right? I'm not. I never played Hotline Miami 2, actually. Keeps coming up on GameDuel. And, yeah, I keep remembering, yeah, sure haven't played that.
You could pass now that you've got 47 jelly beans. Thanks, Hop.
This is also reminding me that Jura Duty was a rather good show. If something, I mean, if a story comes out in a few years that, like, they wildly exploited and the guy in the center of it, that'll be sad, but also a bit unsurprising. A fun trick. Move the stylus over the touchscreen to fire in any direction. Come on, try it on those barrels. Your gumballs will break the green barrels. The color of the gun matches the color of the barrel. Easy peasy. All right, well. Oh, I see. Excellent show. Yes. Yes, I really enjoyed watching it twice. There's a few shows where, like, I'll just watch the whole thing again with my parents. The other ones being a chunk of Breaking Bad. The Witcher, Season 1. I never bothered with the rest. And, yeah, Jura Duty. Amazing he didn't recognize one of the other guys as a recurring character on Parks and Rec. Okay. I didn't recognize any of them, Josh. And not everyone's got a storied knowledge of background actors on those shows like you and me. Or background actors in general, character actors or whatnot. I mean, he does live in California, so you're bound to find a few of those people, but... No, I guess they lucked out. So this is Hop the game. This is where you landed. You died? What, making the desk? What happened? Are you in heaven? Like, what do you mean? That could mean any number of things. Love how bouncy he is. Good for him, man. Good to have a pep in your step sometimes. I'm in Hop the game. Whatever. He says. But you are back now. Internet. Okay. Okay, the chocolate dogs are attacking me. I think I gotta lead them into these rainbow portals. Or maybe I don't. Yeah, I can just kill them. Easy. I killed the chocolate dogs. And now I have a giant red jelly bean on my side. Maybe it'll fight for me. Maybe I can summon it. Anyway, James is really thrilled. Sorry, Fred. This is not the dream job I was looking for. I wish you could be something cool and important, like Sonic the Hedgehog's best friend. And that was it. My high score is 80,000. Next level. Oh, we're doing a minigame? Use the stylus to stop the pink berets where they appear from their rabbit holes. Don't let them surround EB and don't touch any bombs. Okay, it makes a lot of sense if you've seen the movie, I'm sure. I like it was just waiting at the top screen for me to be done. So these portals and these pink beret bunnies are a element in the movie, I imagine. Oh boy. Soundtrack's not bad. Nope. Had a little glitch on my DS there. Yeah, stay in the bag, buddy. How do you wind up making a movie like Hop? Where does that come from? We need an Easter-themed movie in our slate. Don't dump the Easter Bunny. Teach me to be like you. Teach me to be the Easter Bunny. Is that really his arc in the movie? I'm down. Pink berets, Fred. Don't fire at him. Okay. I will kill your rabbit sisters. It's all good. I assume you're all related. Now, is this his house that he's in right now? Because I don't think this place is up to code. He might have said that last time, I forget. In which case, I apologize. So I like how the jelly beans make a little whimpering noise. Almost to suggest they have a soul themselves. I also wouldn't have thought that that jelly beans are like a Easter specific thing, but anyway. While I'm firing. I see. Oh god damn, that is rather brutal. I just chocolateify them, is that it? Wow. Good job, Fred. Savage. Just leaving them to melt then, huh? Very well. Maybe you do have what it takes. More than just a pleasing maroon colored shirt. I think the berets have guns of their own now, I believe is what is being communicated. Got him. Oh, nom nom nom. It's a little Majin Buu coded, isn't it? I gotta make that move at some point. It's funny, you could present most of the games in this. Actually, that'd be a good exercise. How many games could you just show any frame from? And people could still guess what movie it's from. Like, what movie game it's from. I think this one has a significant advantage by virtue of being based on Hop, which would prompt, I feel like, 499 out of 500 people to be like, what was that? Oh man, yeah, Ghoul World. Certainly the Game Boy game of Cool World would be very difficult to understand. To pass, rather. I had forgotten about Hop. Indeed, many have. Cool! Protective shield. Is there a villain in this movie? Other than these berets? Lucky luck tonight. Thank you, Tom. Appreciate it. Yeah, it's funny no one's swapping. It's like, hey, look, I don't mind. Longer sessions. It's not like I'm... Some nights can be like that. At least one, you know? If that means playing 10 minutes of the Hop game for DS, I'm down. I mean, we're just so used to it happening, like, on, like, as soon as the cooldown's over, you know? Alright, what do we got? James Cameron's Avatar. Okay. Yes, I will. Yeah, that's right. I think it's entirely touchscreen controlled, this one. Or at least it feels that way. Can't be worse than the movie! That is the groan of $1 billion worth of cinema revenue being like, oh, but I enjoyed it. It's a good time at the movies. I have no strong feelings about Avatar, for the record. Say it is heinous, and I'll be like, yeah, probably. So, how am I to... Am I able to attack things yet? Anyway, doesn't matter. Hello! You're not allowed to leave. Okay. Have you found out what is happening? No, but things are very strange here. Look around. Where has everyone gone? The village is almost deserted. Still more populated than Monster High. That is very strange. Yes, indeedy. There are guards at the village entrance now. They will not let any of the younger Na'vi leave. Feels like it's a conspiracy. Yeah, I get that. But I think there's just more things at work than how forgettable or not a movie is. It's just a reminder of that. Some things are just pure marketing. What is successful and what is good are just on different tracks. Can't keep the patriarch waiting. I don't know, go see the freaking patriarch. That'd be him, I bet. I love his eyes. What's going on there? He's got really big bug eyes in the overworld, but here it's like very dignified art. Hope you're well today. I am! Amati said you wanted to speak with me? Yes. Today you take up the weapon of our people. I give to you the Na'vi war stuff.
Thank you!
Okay, now I can actually attack. It's dangerous to go alone, Jake Sully. You must train or you risk being as great a danger to yourself as your opponents. Go to the place of learning now. Tutorials typically don't drag out this much, but you know. Antithetical to the medium itself, yes. So you're carrying a war staff, Malcolm. Yes. You must do each attack type 3 times. Are you ready? Okay. Good. You can also slide. Draw a line that divides me and the target. Alright, well. Good work! You can also do a thrust. We draw a line from you to your target. There we go. You got it right! How's everything going in here? You were born to wield it. I know I still have a lot to learn. That you do. More than you realize. I believe Amati is trying to find you. Go and seek him out. And show him your cool weapon. My progress will be saved. Don't you worry about that. We operate on save states here. Okay. Alright, let's just try. Small soldiers for the Game Boy. Alright. Small soldiers, Universal Soldiers, Human Terminals. Licensed by Nintendo. Yeah, I'll keep it on easy. Must find a hiding place. Woo! Cool. Doesn't look like I can use the bow. Okay. Like, I've got the arrow ready to go. But I don't know how to use it. Thankfully, my enemy doesn't know how to attack either. Okay, beat a jump. Oh, if I hold A, I can run. That's right. Okay. Try again. Like, it's weird that I've got the bow and yet I just don't appear to be able to attack anything. Okay. So that's what they want me to do. I do like the sprites. They did nail their designs as well as you could have. Guess I just gotta cheese it through, huh? Am I able to climb up? I don't think so. Okay. I guess I'm gonna do it. Ah, shit. Alright. How did I get up last time? I gotta grab the edge, I guess. There we go. Yep. Oh, man. How embarrassing. There we go. There we go. Alright. Can I make it to the end? That sealing the Gorgonite's fate. That'd be good. Oh boy. Apparently not. Nope. Okay. Okay. Alright. Okay. Okay. And then where do you want me to go, game? Over there? Yep. Good how the gang's are here already. Alright. Alright. Yep. 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 Is that it? Have I made it? Not yet. We gotta get on the boat. Hmm. Where do I go? So funny how I have a bow and I cannot figure out how to use it. Oh, hey now. There is a console small soldiers game as well, but of course, very different to this, as you can imagine. I haven't played that at length, shockingly. Alright. Now what? This seems like something I can interact with. And yet I cannot. What if I just... Okay, I can pause. That's great. Is there a hidden ledge up there that I'm meant to get? I don't know. Who want from me, game? I'm still thrilled about Hunt for Red October. I'm beating Tony on that scoreboard for sure. He won't know what hit him next time I have to write a scoring. I'll be so shocked. Oh, I just had to hit go this way. I overthought it. This should be a safe place. And now I am in our bedroom. That looks identical. Hey, what's up? Haha, that one glitched out. Da. Okay. Whoa! Yeah, caught up with him eventually. There we go. During my daytime tomorrow, so this minus like 6 hours. Not tomorrow, on Thursday. Yeah. So in a couple of days' time, but earlier on, I'll be playing a... As you might have seen on the Discord, I'll be playing a shitload of Halloween-themed picks. Including Land of the Dead, Fiddler's Green, which I got working. And can I tell you, I watched the movie, and that is a really good movie. It's a really good movie. I'm shocked that anyone thought it was like average or whatever the Rotten Tomatoes meter suggested to people. That is a well-written movie. Alright. Tony, get this. Game over Red October. That's quite a rut. And we know what our name's gonna be. Next up, Holgi. Worth it if you watch the movie, yeah. That's the nice thing about doing a 6 hour session with like 6 games. It's like, I'm basically incentivized to, like, move on. So I got other games to play, goddammit. Yeah. Soon after I acquired a copy of Day of the Dead, which I have not watched. I have watched Night of and Dawn, but not Day. And I understand Day is pretty cool, so. Oh, The Incredible Hulk. Excellent. This is Ed Norton movie Hulk, if I recall. Yep.
Begin.
Oh, it's got multiplayer. Good stuff.
My name is Bruce Banner.
Yeah. Tell me more.
I'm trying to stop a monster.
More like the amazing blob. Bulk, rather. Sorry. That's a side scroll? Alright then. Got him.
Are you better? Don't care. Tutorial. Blah.
This is series of unfortunate events ass music. Why is it just like left on the cutting room floor kind of? Ah, I gotta do a rage jump. I see. Why are you... Huh? And then this is a different kind of rage, I guess. I don't know what that satellite's about, but anyway. Ow! Did I actually end up watching the Hulk movie? I can't remember. I genuinely cannot. Maybe I started watching it on a plane or something? God. Anyway. I remember Stanley's cameo, he drinks, like, poison, radiation poison soda, and that's how they track down the Hulk. I figured they were gonna show, watch, there's like green shit in his, oh, look at him do a dance! Oh my god, I killed the Hulk! Alright, and there's your world select screen. Very well. Oh, and I could change my skin.
Bruce Banner.
Thank you for reminding me. How dare you? This film was pretty interesting in retrospect, given how comic book movies developed. I agree. That I remember. And that tells you everything, I think. Ang Lee's Hulk movie, weird and funny and cool at some points. Louis Leterrier's, like, snooze fest. Who cares? Thor Ragnarok, I mean, who cares? Taika Waititi clearly doesn't. Oh yeah, I unlocked Grey Hulk. Thank you. Just seems eternally checked out, that man. Okay. I need to be able to smash shit, you know? I want this to be like the game Rampage, adapted into the movie Rampage, starring Dwayne Johnson. Apparently I played a little bit of the Hulk game for PS2, Ultimate Destruction. And that definitely scratched that itch, so maybe I'm just making that comparison. Oh. I'm meant to perform a rage vault. That's what I was meant to do. Look at that rage vault. A series of films by Uwe Boll called Rampage? Oh, yeah. That was after his video game phase, wasn't it? Yeah, Rampage number one, like his first post-postal movie. I remember only hearing about it via rants by other people. Yes, I figured out the rage jump game, thank you. Press A to lift and draw objects.
Super Mario!
I think it just landed that rock. Oh, I got a new life container. And can I say, I didn't mind She-Hulk. I do mind the exploitation of CG workers. And obviously She-Hulk is clearly the like a house for that sort of thing. Clearly, like, it's, it, you know, where the results of that were the most keenly felt, but, you know.
Dark BMXERS has flown in with 11 viewers. Mamma mia, gay Bowser.
Dark BMXERS. Dark BMXers, I'm gonna guess. Welcome. Oh, Dr. Yasmin too? You're a friend of the good Dr. Yasmin? Oh, you're alright by me. Not that you wouldn't be alright otherwise, but welcome. It's a shuffler. If you've watched Jazz's streams, you know what that is. We love Dr. Yasmin, as you should. Now check it out. It's enchanted. For DDS.
Someone hit the follow button and shattered their hand.
Thank you for hitting the follow button. Sorry about your hand. The viewers aren't all right in the head.
Someone hit the follow button and shattered their hand.
Thank you as well, Dark BMXERS. Which I'm sure everyone calls you. It's okay. I clicked with my non-dominant hand. Good. That is a possibility, isn't it?
Someone hit the follow button and shattered their hand.
Thank you, everyone. The young girl dreamed, and so did I. Good to have you. Let me know what you were up to. You're sad for finishing Daxter? Why is that, TK? There are always more funny games. Oh, because I had Daxter in my graphics, is that why? We're playing Civ 6, getting hyped for Civ 7. That is so close, isn't it? Anyway, Squirrel's talking to us.
Hello there, kids. My name's Pip. I'm one of the critters that lives in the Enchanted Forest of Andalasia.
No time for chit-chat now. We've got to go and wake out Giselle before she dreams away the entire morning. In a 9-hour retro-themed hospital stream recently. Not bad. Oh, you finished it last night? Very good. Here we go. Okay, so I'm not Amy Adams, which is already surprising. Touch Pip with the stars. I like that the stars controls are optional. Wow, he's got a cool jump. Look at him go. Still on offer on GOG for like $1.50. Yeah, I think I've got it already. It's just I'm bad at like sim and RTS games. One day I'll change that. Jump and press up on the control pad to grab onto the ceiling above you. Okay. What a freaking Nobel Peace Prize. Wow. Yeah, this music's nice. Go, Pip, go. Pip can run up or down a wall. I'll tell you what. Whatever child got given enchant of a DS, I think they ate well, you know? There are some games that are just like, look, it's a crappy version of a really good game, but that can be enough for people, you know? Maybe they will end up playing the good game one day. Really got to get out of here to sleep. It's almost 11 p.m. Take care. Have a great rest of the stream. Thank you.
Thank you.
That's for you. Have a good sleep. See the green vine? I sure do. Jump up and grab onto the spider web to take a quick ride down to the goal. Well, never mind. We are Timon. Hello, everyone.
Oh man, this is some fucked up shit right here.
Oh, it's pretty good, I reckon, Dre. Well, it's about time you showed up. Are you ready to scurry, sniff, and flinch? I've been doing nothing but. Timon is the best. Who has seen Lion King 1.5, also known as Lion King 3, in some territories? The hyenas are attacking! Make a run for the colony entrance and avoid those beasts. Okay. Oh, I like how big the hyenas are. I mean, it stands to reason, but you know. Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata. A plus Hakuna Matata, folks. Also, would you believe, TK, this is by the same people who made the Crash Bandicoot GBA games. Like, you can kind of see it, right? It's kind of the same feel. Timon kinda has a Crash Bandicoot feel about him. Holy crap, I might need this. Yeah, look, anything by Vic Visions, you're gonna have an alright time. It's gonna be perfectly acceptable.
Developed by Vicarious Visions.
You'll notice the game got significantly louder. GBA games are just like that. I don't know why. I don't know how to fiddle with BizHawk in a way that, smooth things out. Oh. Okay, that's pretty cool. That's super stupid, but I like it. Okay, what's this move? Oh. I burped, and it's cleared the screen. Eating food, so I'll be lurking for a while, indeed. Make sure to belch in a screen-clearing fashion like our friend Timon. I'm only getting off work in about an hour. Okay. Hope, what, normally? So you got the day off then? Good for you. Hope I'm understanding that correctly. I trusted you to be sentry, and you let the hyena sneak up. I'm sorry, Uncle Max. I'm sorry, Mom. Meerkat life is not for me. I need to find my place in the world. Now to dance.
Oh, look at him trying to approximate the movie story.
I wish I had a friend.
And now I'm Pumbaa. Took it off to watch a haunted house stream. Hey, that's not bad. I'm taking a day off from work today. This week, rather. To, play, horror themed games. We're gonna be playing, let me see if I can name it off the top of my head. Land of the Dead Road to Fiddler's Green for PC. Illbleed for Dreamcast. Destroy All Humans for PS2. Death Smiles for the PC, originally for arcade machines and 360. Yeah, Pumbaa, bear with me, please. What else? I'm trying to remember. Simpsons Road Rage. Hell yeah, in a couple of days. So yeah, at whatever time zone you're in, add a couple of days, and then subtract several hours. Yeah? So like, it's evening for me now, during the daytime in 2 days' time. That's when I'll be doing it. So like, we'll have finished by this time in 2 days. It'll make sense, okay? Also, it should be... I should have a Chrono Channel extension in my about section in my stream. That might tell you in your time zone. I don't know. Anyway. This week might be a simpler answer for you. Anyway. This is great. How many games let you be a belching pig? You'll check and see then. Yeah, no dramas. Even if today is your last day with us, let's make it a good one. Oh, here we go. Rambi. Let's go. If I'm not mistaken, Vic Visions also did a SpongeBob game that we played here on the Shuffler. And it wasn't bad at all. Ah, you can push the boulder to solve the puzzle. I'm trying to think, like, what the... Start out of the many movie games we've streamed for this little thing we do here. It's very hard to pick favorites. Obviously, Hunt for Red October. You'll never guess where I'm writing this comment from. Your phone again? What is that little fellow doing alone in this big place? Ah! Halloween! Come back. But first, a victory dance. Oh, from your desk? Your next two streams are tomorrow and the first. I gotta work on the first, so I should still see ya. Oh, your first screen? We back? Oh, cool. Excellent. I'm glad that worked out. Where did he go? I need to find that guy and make sure he doesn't get into trouble. That's rather selfless. Take that, Sonic. Yes, my desk.
Very good. Everybody congratulate Josh on his new desk. I hope it was affordable and sturdy. Worth the blood, sweat, and tears. This game is fucking adorable. It's not bad. It's not bad. Look, if it, like, I think I would actively dislike it if it turned out to just be a minigame collection, but I love it. I love a doofy platformer based on a kid's movie. That will always win my heart. Why can't there ever be a tunnel when you need one? And it's clearly, like, taken dialogue from the movie, because it just doesn't really make a lot of sense. Dad got it. It's sturdy. It's also not really designed for a PC. What do you want me to do? You want me to do this? So once again, the hyena racism is alive and well in the world of Lion King. There's no Ken Lee Trey. Is that third word meant to be spelled like that? Because I don't recognize it as anything. Sorry. Cable. There you go. We got that. We got that. Hey, I got a remote. Oh. Hello, Timon.
Don't eat me!
I'm not going to eat you.
Are you alone too? Yes. If only there was some phrase to bind us together. Hello, Tante. Check out the bonus movie. Oh, that's the stuff. Thank you for the compliment on my don't eat me. Probably like Rush Hour. Yes. Time to watch Shrek. I love how you looked at the list and you're like, nah.
I'm lurking, have fun.
You have fun too, Tante. Thank you for your luck. Oh, he hit his balls and cock. The swapping is cool. I'm glad. Yeah, I thought it would be too. And it has definitely turned out that way. And yeah, if you go exclamation mark swap and then the exact file name as it appears in that pastebin list that Tante just threw up, you can swap to a specific game, but by default, it will be random. And it'll drop a save state where I am and just move on. Which is why we're starting from this scene well into the movie. Now, we watched a good 10 minutes of this last time, and YouTube finally got wise and realized what I was watching. In previous sessions, it hasn't. We're gonna get it to a new game before we get to the end of this cutscene. Well, if you say so, it'll probably happen. But I'm implementing a new, like, we need to, like, I will swap myself if we finish a complete scene beginning to end. So if we go to this next scene, which if I recall, it's like, according to my neighbor's app, there's been sirens going off all morning. Haven't heard anything but the TV and the stream is loud. Oh, damn. I hope nothing's going all right in your neighborhood. Feel free to step away and investigate.
A little unorthodox, I'll admit, but thy deed is great and thine heart is pure. I am eternally in your debt. And where would a brave knight be without his noble steed?
All right, I hope you heard that. She called me a noble steed. You think I'm a steed?
The battle report back soon.
Yeah, do. Oh, hello. Treasure Planet. Let's go. The battle is won. It's time for Treasure Planet. Standing up is hard. Sure it is. All right. What am I meant to be doing, sir? Can I punch you? Oh, hell yeah, Treasure Planet, that's right. Oh, we're collecting surfer parts, I guess? Alright. Hey, now we're talking. I love his stupid jump. Look at him. I'm a bird.
Yeah.
I like the 100 coins. Get an extra life. Gems are worth 5 coins, but they're rare. Okay. I had the PS2 version of this, and I enjoyed it a lot. It was a good Jack and Dexter substitute before I actually went ahead and got Jack and Dexter. I found a gym. Maybe this is where I was meant to go the entire time. I remember wandering around outside for ages last time I played this. Let's get all the loose change left behind by the people who've stayed in these rooms. And we ought to punch things also. Oh, I got a new morph move. It'll help me look further, helping you to avoid dangerous things. Hold the L button, press A and B to cycle through. To activate a morph move, press the R button. Some morph moves can require you to press R and a direction at the same time. Yep, cool. That's cool. It's always fun when you get, like, relatively human-looking characters. Like, obviously this isn't a Disney movie, but so... It's very stylized, human proportions, but... It's always fun them trying to make that work on in GBA sprites. Let's go and meet Doppler at the police station, like you said. Police, police! Yeah, I know, they're all bastards. Yes, Mom. Fuck authority, we're pirates. I know. Well, Jim, I tried to reason with them, but they won't let you have your surfer back. I'm not going to leave Montressa without my surfer. I built it from scratch and they can't take it away from me. I'm afraid they can, Jim, and they're going to destroy it. No! I'm gonna go in there and get it back. Well, that's the other thing. I've got the ball in there. The rest has been sold for scrap. Should find out who it went to. Mines for spares, and the engine was sold to the ironworks for scrap metal. I'm going in here to get my board back. Okay, Jim. I got a longboat waiting. Forward. Alright. All quiet outside. No idea what's going on for the people that posted. Oh, yeah. Well, I'm glad nothing's wrong. Spinning drones are very easy to dodge, but watch out. They hurt if you touch them. Swell. What's fun doing this? Like, we've done this. This is maybe the 5th time I've done this stream. Or 6th. And I don't think we're even halfway through all the games I've got. Which is really fun. There's still so many we can delve into. It is delightful. Jim's health bar is in the bottom right corner of the screen. If Jim is reduced to 0 hearts, he will die. He will restart at the beginning of the level. Okay. Don't touch drones, is the takeaway. Beware, spikes take Jim's health. Must they? You will find locked doors on your adventure. You may need to complete a task. You can see which color key you need by the panel next to the door. I'm thinking red and blue. Just a hunch. Let's see which is behind this door. Electric floors will hurt Jim and knock him back. Whee! Whee! Yahoo! Don't die, that's something we do every day, or better or worse. Correct! To turn on a switch, stand on it with Jim. Don't step on any switches without Jim. Yep. Yep. Switch has been unlocked. Hell yeah. Alright. Okay. Go here. And then up here. Nice. I'm gonna get all the coins and gems.
Extra life.
Way to go.
Robot cop can see you if you stand in front of it. Robocop reference. Sorry for the ad break. You'll get it in the next minute. Yes, I remember this thing. Yep. Legally distinct Robocop, really. Okay, can't go that way. Man died and forced him, and they forced him back to work. Robocop. Yes. But they made him cool and marketable. And part of it a re-election strategy? I don't remember the finer details of the first film. I'm sure Frank Drescher can remind us. Like, it was the police that rebuilt him, more or less, right? Because he was publicly funded, if I'm not mistaken. Corporate funded, okay. Is law enforcement just privatized in that world? Probably. Again, I don't remember the finer details. I should watch it again, it rocks. I would have a great time. Oh, please. Caught you, now get out. What if I did not? What if I went straight back in, bitch? Alright. Dale, nice meeting you. Pro streamer for real. Good show. Thank you, Phoebus. Appreciate you saying so. That's lovely. Have a good rest or whatever else you intend to do with your free time. A little smattering of applause for you. You deserve it. Robocop doesn't like me. He knows I'm up to no good. But I will carry on collecting coins on the bookshelves. Confidence in the stride is great. Yeah, I like it too. He's got real swag, this boy. This young man, he has swag. And then some. By activating the checkpoint, you will respawn here. Ooh, yeah. Set down at the desk, set the driving wheel pedals down, wonder where I put the power brick, and then make myself learn how to drive at 39 before it's too late. And is that a manual or automatic? There's a corporation that sold all the technology to the police department, streamlined by a corrupt man. Yeah, cool. I should just watch it again. Oh, I see. The death buttons. The buttons that eat people. I have manual gears extension for the Logitech too. Yeah, very cool. And what, perchance, are you playing? A bit of F1? A bit of Gran Turismo? A bit of Forza? Euro Trucks? Nice. 12 gears, yeah, that would. I have manual gears extension. Oh, sorry, I read that. Good realistic driving game with normal gears, I see. I'm sure you will find what you need. It's not a genre I know well, but I'm always impressed. Suggestions, anyone? Oh yeah, that activates my suggestion box. Ignore that. Yeah, no, it's not a genre I know well, so. Sorry. But maybe someone else can help you out. Up a 200 IQ. No, I just taught it to recognize the word suggestion. That's all. Oh.
Someone hit the follow button and shattered their hand.
Thank you for shattering your hand. Hope it was your non-dominant one. You need to turn them off to get past. Very well, very well. No McDonald gift? Love it. I mean, it's an emote, but anyway. It starts life as a gif. I suggest Nightbot should use commands. Tom is was a god. Rip, funny buddy. Yeah. Oh, they caught me. I thought I'd hit all the buttons and it was rewarding me, but no. You had a lot of good bits, that man. Yeah, I know how laser fences work, thank you. There we go. Haha! Press the buttons again all you like, puppy! Yeah, I have the red key. It's gonna open the red doors. Time for March of the Penguins for Game Boy Advance. Here's one we've never played. DSi! This predates that, thank you very much. Snowball, or a soft landing. Hot coal melts icicles, fish attracts the penguins, and tents can be used as a trampoline. Ice slides, ice ramp, ice bridge, ice steps. Very good. Alright, good to know. And all the audio sliders we could possibly need. This is the incredible true story, in the harshest place on Earth, of a family's journey to bring life into the world. Chapter 1. The Emperor Penguins start their perilous journey across the harsh landscape of Antarctica. To advance to the next chapter, collect at least 12 snowflakes, just like in the documentary, and get all penguins to the breeding colony before time runs out. I remember seeing this at theaters with a friend, and this older couple got mad at us for laughing at one part. It's fucking lemmings! Bro! Is Dr. Yasmin still here? Oh my god! Hell yeah!
Bring out the gimp.
No, not yet, Gex. Penguins are plenty gimpy as it is. It's true. Oh, wow. Oh, that's brilliant, dude. I guess the snowball... Yeah, I've got to collect the snowballs. Okay, yeah. Yeah, I'm quite sure. Okay, I get it now. I get it now. Lemons. Are you eating them at this moment? What's the story? Yeah, hang on. I gotta really brush up on what the tools are. So, snowballs for soft landing, hot coal melts icicles, fish attracts penguins, tents are what I need to bounce up, okay. Is this a takeoff ramp? Climb up to another level, okay, yep. That is a very sick game concept for this movie, yeah. It's exactly the right concept. It's cool. I like that it appears that I have an unlimited supply of all the things to use. There's also a DS version of this. Just FYI. Which I imagine would be fun. Look at him go! Okay, so they bounce a bit and then they... Alright, but now, courtesy of Tom, it is time for Meet the Robertsons for the Game Boy Advance, I think. Yeah, it is Game Boy Advance. I think they had a DS game as well, but anyway. Ooh, look at that art. Very good. Wilbur Part 1. Incredible username. I love it. It is a very good one. Let's have a look at the options. Music on, sound effects on, help on, and we can look at credits, should we desire. Thanks again for everything. Now don't make me come back to bail you out again. You better get going. See you later, Wilbur. Now to go home. To the future. That was the greatest adventure yet. But even secret agents need a little break now and then. Bleep, bleep, bleep. Hey, look, I'm assuming we don't have enough goodies right now. We gotta unlock them in the course of the game. You can start on the flower pots. Sheesh! You leave the garage one time and they act like it's the end of the world. Bowler hats, what the? But how? I had better take care of this mess before anybody else finds out and gets me into more trouble. If I can find a blueprint and some invention pieces, I should be able to make something that can get rid of these things. I can use batteries to power my invention, but if I run out of them, I'll be game over. Build the pizza gun.
destroy all the little Dorises. Find the invented egg timers, 10 of them, and then find the present. Very well. Excellent. Hey. You're awesome. You're awesome. Hi. You will lose a battery if a little Doris attacks you. You must build a pizza gun in order to destroy the little Dorises. Okay. Woo! Find egg timers. Press and hold the R button to duck. Press left or right on the control pad to roll. Whee! Excellent. Boom! 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 Excellent. You have found the pizza gun blueprint. Now find 3 invention pieces, and you will make the invention. It was that easy. For Einstein and others. You have found 1 of 3 pizza gun invention pieces. Thank fuck. Push or pull boxes, stand next to them, press the B button. Be sure your invention is unequipped. Or you will create a wormhole and die. That's a cool invention right there. But watch out for it. I'll drain your batteries. Put away your invention. Face the switch. Press the B button. Boink. Whew. Invention piece number 2. Pizza gun will be here shortly. Inspiration will strike. Yes, it will. Oy! Why are they called Dorises? I haven't seen the movie. If I finish any game I finish, I gotta watch something eventually. As part of it. The only thing we finished is Shrek Super Slam, and so I will watch Far Far Away Idol. When it's appropriate. I forgot to before 13 Ghosts the other night on the Discord, but that's okay. We will remedy that in time. What I might do actually is, like, when I watch an entire feature film as part of this, I'll just use Far Far Away Idol as a pre-feature presentation like that. A sort of Pikachu's Vacation of sorts. I think that's a great plan. What's stunningly average music? I hope the composer did not try too hard. I like that Wilbur could just keep somersaulting over and over. But how will we vote on the winner? I'll have the text line set up. 50 cents per message. Australian. Each direction on the control pad changes a different group of lights. Once all the lights are green, the invention will be activated. Oh, great. It's one of these. Can't you just let me point and click? Oh yeah, hot dogs. I remember hot dogs. That was Big Brother, right? That he was in. There's a reference I get. Incredible name for a human being. I hope he's doing well. Hold the L button to view your inventions. At least the L button and press B to fire. Equip an invention by holding the L button using the control pad. Well, exhaustive tutorials. Using your inventions. Fancy batteries. You will lose it and have to find a replacement. Press the B button to fire the pizza gun. You have activated the pizza gun. Thought you'd never ask. You have found a battery.
What, someone think of the hot dogs?
No, Tom, you gotta understand. Real person named hot dogs. It was an important part of Australian culture. I don't think he does, Josh. That's the point. Using pizza as a weapon seems like the worst use of pizza gun.
Yeah, that's true.
We have found an Invenco egg timer, so I can destroy the crates. Oh, well, never mind. Who cares? Back to Penguin. More trampoline. Trampoline! No hot dogs for you. Oh. Oh, they're stuck. Oh my word. Well, you know what we can do about that? Maybe? No? They're stuck, baby. Please. Oh my word. Oh. Whee! That's alright. Oh no! They dead! No! Well, they had a good time. I think we can agree. Oh, hang on. I hope we've seen, like, Morgan Freeman will reveal himself. That is my wish. Very pixelated. Lemmings with less death. Nah, gonna try and get some sleep. Hope the rest of the swapping is fun. Thank you, Sifra. If that is how you pronounce it. Probably not, but we'll learn. I haven't got all the snowflakes anyway, so I'm not going to bother with that. Although, it would be fun to put them on a slide again, so let's just try this. Make a slide for the penguins, you idiot! No, okay, never mind. Incredible music. Go, penguins! Well, fuck. Yes. Well, fuck the game. And the softballs are for soft landing, they said? Okay. Okay, now we have the same predicament. Don't turn around! Don't turn around! Where are you going? Oh, man. Oh, brother. Is there even water here in this version of the Antarctic? Who could say? I don't see it. What did you want me to do here again? They're really throwing me into the thick of it, which I appreciate on one level. But on another, I am traumatized. God be with anybody who had this game growing up. I hope they're doing okay. Is that what we want? No, clearly not. They are quietly judging my pitiful attempts at... Oh, you know what? Was that it? Yeah, that was it. That's what the soft landing is. Oh, okay. And then they use the ramp to get up there. Delightful. Oh, and then, okay, well. Somebody get those snowflakes. Boing, boing. Is that the end? God, this level goes for ages. Oh my word. I can use the shoulder buttons to scroll, which is good. I'm just gonna set up this stuff ahead of time. If I could just, yeah. There's no speed up though, is there? There may well be, I haven't figured it out yet. I've been playing this for a rule of not even 10 minutes. Give me a break. I guess that'll work. Surely. I mean, he seemed to jump at the very top of the ramp, right? No? Yes? You gonna do it? We'll never know. It's time for Obi-Wan's adventures. You took me way too literally! Smartass! How dare you! No, I'm keen to play this. If I could just get past all the freaking logos. Jesus.
Hey, look at that. Oh, drink it in. That's the stuff. This is story content right here. Pure cinema. Look at that. Fuck cinemas. They are dead. All we have is Game Boy. Away we go. Trade Federation ship. The negotiations will seem to have broken down, my Padawan learner. Look at his face! If you could call it that. You must reach the hangar to escape and warn the planet of the danger. It's time at last to test your skills, Obi-Wan. Up until now, you've been fucking useless, brother. My face is scrunched up listening to that face. Oh, look at this. Oh, combat has activated. Yeah. This rocks. Was that a pleasurably scrunched up face, or? This is a pretty high tech for Game Boy Color, yes. I agree. Episode 1 is worth it just for giving us games that allow us to kill the battle droids. They are just so funny and such great fodder. I love them quite a bit. Jedi Survivor, of course, is the peak of this. Listening to them jabber amongst themselves is great. Absolutely the highlight of that game. Let's explore the rest of this environment. I found health upgrades. How cool. Oh, I can... Oh, hell yeah. I use select to change my weapon. I got a pistol! With limited ammo, so I should only use it sparingly. Alright. And then this... The bottom right indicates what the A button does, I think. No, it's what the B button does, yeah. Oh, this rocks. Man, the Darth Maul fight in this is gonna be off the chain. Can't wait. I don't know why that took a while, but anyway. Got him. Hello, droids. I'm gonna turn you into gonks. No arms, just funny noise. That'll be you. I hope I actually see a gonk droid in this. I love that as like a gun pickup sprite. That's great. I like his little footstep noises. That's great. This is just a quality product. I'll kill you! I'm deflecting bullets on purpose. There we go. We got there. Seems like the safest option. Bloop, bloop, bloop. And then we'll get this as well. What? Oh, have I got to do them in a certain order?
Yes, I think I do. Alright, we get this one first. And then this one. And then this one. Yeah! Gamer! That's me. Oh, okay. I'm gonna be slashing the air like this, and if you get slashed, it's your own fault. But how did you figure it out? Gamer. I told you. That's my secret, Cap. I'm Gamer. These destroyable? I don't think so. I don't think so. Alright.
Master, he's on the pointless conveyor belts! Leave him alone. He'll get confused and sick and dizzy. Like a small puppy. On conveyor belts.
Can I go up here? No.
It's the ultimate Jedi trap! Oh! Is that legal?
Anakin, did I ever tell you about the time I got caught in the conveyor belt room? It was very exciting and confusing all at once. I also recall being a little bit hungry. There was a lot going on that day.
Master, I would have easily overcame the conveyor belts. I'm built different.
So not something at the end of that? Yeah, there probably was, and I missed it. I don't know. There's probably something simple like that I've got to press, and I've just skipped it by entirely. Listen to this John Williams chiptunes, huh? It's so good. This is surely what he intended all along. I did confuse the Jedi. I'm Jedi! I'm Jedi. That's me. Maybe it's down here. I don't know. Oh, never mind. Driving me a little crazy. Well, yeah, that's why you have the power. Alright. Alright, Buzz, what do we do here? You have quite an impressive head, even in 8-bit. Oh, Rex, why? Doesn't matter. Rex killed me. I'll exact my revenge later. This is a nice loop, surely. To infinity and somewhere. Alright. Hey, buddy.
Nuh-uh-uh, Buzz.
Rude. I said I would kill you. That day is not today, apparently. Significantly different to the PS1 game, would you believe it? I want you to join Space Ranger. Yeah, this is an alternate universe where everyone hates Buzz. Akin to how they hated Woody in Toy Story 1. Maybe that's the plot of this game. It's a role reversal. Multiversal saga. Nice. Alright. Clearly I'm meant to go this way. Whoop. Yeah! Come on, man. Where do I go if not this way? I mean, there's a coin up there. Come on, bro. What do I do? Alright, stuff it. I'm gonna fly this way. See if that gets me anywhere. Oh yeah, no, that's right. I can take a run up, can't I? Didn't matter. Alright. I'll get you yet, alien. Yeah, take that, Rex. Where do I go? What do I do? That's my Buzz impression. Come on, man. It's hard to properly judge what he's gonna do at a given moment. I need you to understand. This is quite confusing. Maybe I gotta hit that doorknob and go out the main door. Maybe that's what's gonna happen. Nope. Alright, never mind. Oh, Buzz, we're in such a pickle here. Everyone hates you, and you have no plan. You're in some Groundhog Day-style nightmare scenario, and you gotta find Woody and sort it out. Or maybe you're like Plankton, and you've got a button that can send you back at any moment.
Goodbye, everyone! I'll remember you all in therapy!
Come on, bro. Just... Alright, doesn't matter. Finding Nemo continuing adventures. The sequel to Finding Nemo. There wasn't any other. Okay, how do I do this? I mean, I've got shoulder buttons. Will that help? Okay, so I jump with A. Okay. And I can build up speed, I guess? This'll work.
Ah!
Oh dear. It's fine. Everything's okay. Okay, I meant to pick up tiles along the way. This guy definitely had a name, but hell if I could remember it. I don't think I'll be collecting all the tiles on this playthrough. Okay, I see an arrow on the ground. I'm gonna follow it.
You.
Now to hang out. Hi, Nemo. I found you. Next. Okay. Oh, interesting. I can play as multiple characters. Look at this. All right, we're sticking with Bubbles, I guess. Let's play a mini game. Bubbles! Uh-oh, I better pop all these bubbles if I want to get Bubbles back to the reef. Oh, that was his thing. He liked bubbles, and so he was called Bubbles. Press the buttons that appear in the bubbles to pop them before they reach the top of the screen. If you miss three times, game's over. Is this the game? No, it's not that one. No, that was regular Finding Nemo. And we overcame that challenge. What is this, a mini game for children? Bubbles, please. Get a hold of yourself. Oh, I could build up a chain, apparently? Yeah, nice. So if I wait longer... Cool. Alright. I could get combos. Two chain. Yeah, that is a bug face he's doing, isn't it? Three chain. B, up, down, up, down, chew, chew, chew. How funny that I have to do each individual character. Replayability. I think this is a VicVision's joint as well, if I'm not mistaken. Or a similarly reputable studio. Bubble Rings! Right, so it's just a bunch of minigames. I'm down. Swimming through the reef, these bubbles sure looks fun. Swimming through these bubbles sure looks fun. Let's try that. Swim through the target number of bubbles to win the game. Okay, so now bubbles are great. Dart through the bubble ring. Very good. Oh, it's a Crash Bandicoot level, basically. Right, so it's not... Okay. I see what this is. It's okay.
Like I said earlier, I frowned on the minigame collection as a solution for adapting these movies. It's a little easy. You gotta make a really dumb approximation of the movie plot in platformer form, or it's not valid in my eyes. You're out of contention for goat material, you know? Yeah, I think I've got the high score. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I do. Bubbles is cheering me on. I appreciate it. You're running out of time. No, I am not. Yeah. I smashed it. You're welcome, Bubbles. Alright. Bubble puzzle. It really is just minigames. Alright then. I'm not going any further until I see some bubbles. Big bubbles. I don't even make enough big bubbles. Very well. Bubbles are combined to create larger ones for bubbles to pop. Is it a match throw? Mini-sized bubbles can be pushed together to make large bubbles. Buddy, just make bubble at this point. The player pushes the bubbles up, right, left, and down, and then you pull the bubbles. Points are scored when a bubble pops the large bubbles. If several large bubbles are formed at the same time, bonus points to the number of chain. Try to get... Yeah, okay. What bubbles is nonsense now? It is. That reminds me, I heard someone on the radio refer to Michael Bublé as, boobs. And I thought, surely he knows. Surely they're aware. Michael Booby. That's it. The very same. Okay, cool. I get it. I don't love the bubble physics, but I'll take it. Two chain. Three chain. Four chain. Maybe they're like bubble specific minigames, to be fair. Like maybe I won't be able to do this with any of the other characters. Unless all the characters are fascinated by bubbles now. But then, what is Bubbles' thing, if not bubbles? Time for the Jungle Book. This is an excellent version of Bare Necessities. Jungle by day, get ready. Well, that's me, I'm Mowgli. Oh, what a fucking jump on this kid. Well, this is Jungle Book. Indisputable. And yeah, that's a precious gem, which Mowgli famously coveted. Nope, alright. I don't want to be like you. Sorry. I want to be Donkey Kong. I wanted to play Donkey Kong Land instead of this. No, I like this. They like me, shooby dooby dooby. You are now grapes. Suck shit. Oh boy. Congratulations, you completed the game! Yes. It's got a very Sonic the Hedgehog sounding skit. I like it. I got a banana! I was running short on those. Oh, look at that. I turned the snake into a gem. That's the way to do it.
That's how we do it. In the jungle. Book. A shovel! Yeah! Bagheera? Is that the name of the panther? I'm getting it wrong. But I bet he never let Mowgli have a shovel. Yeah, it is? Yep, cool. Bagheera and Baloo, the bear, who has the same voice actor as Scatman Crothers, the cat, the orange cat from Aristocats. No, he's got a particular name. I don't remember it. Like George? Well, he's Garfield, yes. Cool, I can join the dramatic arts! Alright. What? Man, a lot of leaps of faith in this game. Fucking hell. It's two orange cats that have voice Baloo. Is that true? Oh, yes, it is. 100%. That is 100% true because Bill Murray played him in the remake. Yes. I figured out what you were selling. And right on cue, it's time for Rain of Fire. Which. Bam! Oh, wow. Spyglass. Crawfish. Oh. French. Oh, I can't play as the dragon yet, but I will. This is Mature Gaming. Hello.
Someone hit the follow button and shattered their hand.
Thank you for hitting the follow button. Welcome to Rain of Fire. I can't understand the dialogue, because I ain't French. Oh, wow, we're a squad? Look at us. Oh my word, what is going on? Ooh, this runs like crap. Oh my god. Wow. Wow. Dale. As some say. La merde. Okay, we got a compass pointing us in the right direction. Come on, boys. Let's defeat the dragon. All right. Intercept the something or other. Ratatouille at the base. And then join me in the attic. All right. Oh, I got a different objective now. Study is still a mess, but double desks is set up quite nicely. Cool. Welcome to Rain of Fire, bro. Okay, Pitbull. Monsieur Wilbad. I know you love it. Alright, where am I going? I love that the enemies go down in one hit. And that I am multiple guys. This is great. That's why it couldn't last. Time for Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs 2 for DS. Oh, it's Game Mill. Game Mill Entertainment has published this. Now, Game Mill, I'm better known lately for that horrible Kong game that looked like shit. If you want crappy license games, they are your one-stop shop. Oh, man. French Pitbull stream? Not likely, but thank you. Wow, I can barely believe we're finally here. Can your ideas change the world? Yes, Chester V. Poster, they can. I have not seen either of the movies. First, I'm going to need to gather my greatest ideas. Use touchscreen to swipe across the notes as they appear. Try to grab as many as you can. It's a mini game collection. Of course. It's a good call out though, I'll tell you what. So it's the same on both screens, but like, they just need one as an input. It's like, what do we put in the backdrop? I don't know. What images do we have handy? Strawberry with a face on it. Go ahead. Yeah, it's Fruit Ninja. Well, Dr. Yasmin would not tolerate that. All right. Pirates of the Caribbean in Spanish.
Dead Man's Chest for DS. Game Boy Advance, rather. A maze. I hope there are mazes.
Do you fear death? 100 souls.
There's my Davy Jones for you. Let's go. Ooh, all right, straight in. Hello, Johnny Depp. I should have known I'd find you here. Tutorial parrot, let's go. Fuck yeah. That's all right. Okay. Goodness me. Love that it's a parrot. Yeah, that's where it should be every time, really.
Oh, guardia!
Press button B. And press... And then jump in the air with A. Alright. So better... Okay. Okay. Very good. Yes. I'll be fine. Just did that little... You just need that little clicking sound Davy does. Oh, yeah, done. I don't know. I tried. But I know what you're looking for. The cat does it too. That cat with the oval mouth. I can't do it very well. Sort of like that. Smash the barrels. You don't need to tell me, parrot. Well familiar. Oh, I like how the coins disappear. Oh, matey. Do I need to unlock a double jump for Captain Jack? Is that what's gonna happen here? I'm hitting the L button, which just making some kind of ching noise. We got damage numbers? Alright. Fucking RPG areas, let's go. Barrel chickens! That's how you restore health. But the parrot told me that, and I just couldn't understand its advanced language. Okay. This is for throwing at enemies, I imagine. Cool sprites, who made this? That's a good question. I missed it entirely. Amaze Entertainment, actually. I think that's the developer. It may well be the publisher for all I know. No, the publisher would be Disney. What am I saying? Amaze Entertainment. And I don't recall seeing their name on any other games. But if you told me this was way forward, I'd believe you. Hail, Time Wars. Yes, thank you, Time Wars. Aggressiveness. Love your face. Yeah, we love Tante's face. We are pro Tante's face. I'm gonna do this for myself more than anything. Who joined us? It was Dark BMXs. Just a bit overdue. But then it creates a little handy follow button for my sake. Anybody who hasn't, give Dark BMXs a follow. If they're a friend of Dr. Yasmin's, they're a friend of mine. Ah, today's Gamdel? Don't mind if I do. Let me save where I'm up to in this. And then, sorry, Barbie and the Island Princess, you will have to wait. Okay. I'm here from Ducks. I was lurking. And we love lurkers. We are big lurking fans. Big, big fans. Okay. And Stair Dismount from Josh. If you're not familiar with either, don't worry about it. Okay. Time for a bit of Gamdel. Alright, start with the classic. Gotta guess a game from its cover. That looks like For Honor. And I'm correct. I'm so good. I'm ever so good. Snacking and lurking, that's good. Okay, that, I'm pretty sure. Well, it's one of two things. And I got a first try. Alright, we're sailing through it today. Amaze Entertainment did indeed make the Pirates game. Cool. Anime, Monarchy, and Nobodies. Okay. We're getting there.
Yeah.
Had to be one of them. Kingdom Hearts is a special place on this stream. Alright. Pirates of the Caribbean. Lego Pirates of the Caribbean, sure. This is like Wordle, this bit. You just gotta guess the game from the hints they give you after making guesses. Alright, so it's third person, but Disney have nothing to do with it. It's more recent than 2011. Let's go the classic new first person, third person game that I always go with. Jedi Survivor. Okay, it is Unreal Engine, but it's a bit older. And it's not strictly a single player game. That's good to know. Let's try Final Fantasy. Actually, why don't we just try Kingdom Hearts again? I know 3 is Unreal Engine, so... Alright, it's older than Kingdom Hearts 3. No Square Enix involved. Good to know. I don't think Ubisoft has made anything in the Unreal Engine. I'm taking off publishers now. Nor do I think Nintendo have done such a thing. Third person games. Unreal Engine games. I gotta think of something. It'd be nice and broad. It's almost too many choices. And yeah, I haven't narrowed anything down in terms of platforming, but we know it's like a sort of traditional adventure game at least. We know that much. Covered off EA. I gotta make this simple. Come on now. Alright, look. Unreal Engine games. Come on now. Why am I making this difficult? Yeah, more recent. Oh, Batman Arkham? Or Borderlands? No, Borderlands is first person. Was that Batman I spoke? Yeah, the Batman Arkham games. Alright. Arkham Knight. It's not, but we've narrowed down the year dramatically. Very cool. Alright, what else are we looking at? Deadpool the game? Sure, why not? Alright, we got the right year. Give us a clue. Starbreeze Studios. Is it Brothers? I saw Brothers in the list. Yeah, it is Brothers. Cool.
Woo!
Alright. Having done that. Thank you, Rage Racer. It is now time for the other thing that was redeemed, which is a little bit of stair dismount. Whoa, whoa. Where? Where? Whoa, whoa. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's a body part. Your heading is 527. There we go. And then the pitch. Make it a 54-36. Alright, that's what we're looking at. Alright, you're pointing towards the stairs, which is great, and your target force is like 13. Is there anything you want to change about this one, Josh? It looks pretty good to me, but I'll give you some time to think about it. What do you reckon? Dang, this is good. For another camera angle, just to inform your decision. Do I want to cheese it? I mean, your target force is pretty much... Like, I'm only going to try and guess 13, so I'll probably end up maxing out force anyway. So maybe you want to, I want my lead back, okay. Go into his back. Dead center into his back, alright, sure. That would be it then. Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5! What a gracious fall. Look at that. Oh my word. Oh, Josh. Unreal. And yet, Juby, still on top. But boy, were your heels snapped at just now. Wow. Wow.
Woo!
Incredible. Just majestic. One more time. Just a brilliant plan. It's just got a, you know, Juby just had a slightly better one somehow, you know? Damn. Juby, for the record, I don't know if you heard me mention it, but we're going to wipe the high school table start of next year. So there'll be a 2024 champion and then we'll start 2025. That's how that'll work. Okay, now let's get the shuffler started again. We've got how much longer? Half an hour. Yeah, we could do a little bit more shuffler. Do I win anything?
No.
You don't. I'll record it somewhere that you're the 2024 champion. But no. Sadly, I reserved the VIP diamonds for people. I've met you in real life.
I can't believe they make us wear these ridiculous ties.
I don't recall that. But Juby, I have met you in real life, so you deserve a VIP diamond. That's my rule for VIP diamonds. That's why I give them out. Because I don't want to get into this gray area of just like, you know, they're on my stream a lot, but I don't know if they're worthy of a VIP. No, it's just a flat rule. If we've met in real life, you get it. So you're eligible. So you'll get one. Where did you meet Juby? That was before Tom Walker. Am I wrong? Or am I thinking of someone entirely different? Yeah. No, be kind to Josh. There was a lot of things he was doing around that time. It's a whole comedy festival. There were a lot of people he met. All right. Who wants to do the honors? Either we go back to what we were playing or we just swap to something else. The swap command is ready for anyone wanting it. Planet of the Apes, let's go. Thank you, Dr. Yasmin. Ubisoft, a better time. Taurus Games, Australian. And I believe this is the Tim Burton. The Tim Burton movie. Deutsch! Planet der Affen, start drooking. The Maravadu. Alright, we all know the plot of Planet of the Apes. That's Mark Wahlberg. He's going to have a little nap. And now it's a... Oh, now this is a cinematic platformer. Check this shit out. Oh my goodness. No, I do not speak as a Deutsch. Absolutely not. This rocks. Somebody called James MK. Press B to... It's Prince of Persia. That's right. Oh my goodness. An Australian made Prince of Persia for Game Boy Advance. And it's Planet of the Apes. Incredible. It's legit. Yeah, it is everything. We've jokingly said it about... There's an ad break incoming. I am not letting that ad break happen right yet, right at this minute. Thank you very much. This is much too important. Look at that! How cool! Environmental puzzles. Let's go. The jump's a little wonky, but that's fine. Holy shit, dude. Let's go. I'm legit gonna clip this out and show James MK later.
It's like, yeah, this is it. This is what you wanted. The art is good, I agree. Okay. Got him. God damn. This is like 2.5 days. Sorta, yeah. Oh, I've got to collect the flags. I'm gonna quit, and then I'm gonna be collecting the flags, okay? I want all the flags. I wanna get everything in this game. This is too interesting to me. This is like, this might be the gem in the rough I've been looking for. This is cool. How funny. Oh, you can do a little roll, look at him! Woo! Hell yeah. Yeah. They're real nice animations, they're so good. You don't need to rotoscope that shit, it's fine. You ain't got a Jordan Mechner it. Wink. Alright, I don't know what the flags do, but I want them all. Impossible to dislike, that's right. Even the music rocks, it's just nice. It's just all these nice flourishes to it. All the symbols and shit, yeah. Roll is great. It's not official or beneficial, but it looks cool. And I know. There's value to that. And who knows, maybe it'll come in handy later. Yeah, closer. I haven't even seen an ape yet, and I love it. Soon, though. The low scooch. Yeah, exactly. You need a low scooch in these things. Woo! Just calmly leans into it. This man is training. Alright. Oh man, I'm so glad I kept going with the shuffler tonight. I had a brief moment of just like, have I streamed enough? No, I hadn't. This is why. Hell yeah. Oh, look at that animation. Unbelievable. Hell yeah, powering on, that's right. And Dr. Yasmin, you can credit yourself for this too. You were the one that hit go on the swap. I know it was random, but you can take credit. You're allowed. Flag on left. I know. Trust me, I know. I don't know what they do, but I ain't missing a one. God, how cool. Now it's like, okay, what other cinematic platformers came out on the Game Boy Advance? Surely Prince of Persia. Surely. The stream continues at my grace. Ah, we found the apes. Can I, okay. I can't gently lower myself backwards off the ledge, but that's okay. Assume I gotta kill the ape? That's a bit gnarly, but okay. Whoop. Hang on. I got this. Woo! Alright. Too bad. First ape kill. First blood. Just killed the guy I'm provoked. Did I? He was a damn dirty ape. He had to die. Won't come back to haunt me at all. It'll be fine. Alright, we got time bonus as well. Fair enough. Oh my god! 3 out of 4 apes? So if I left an ape alive, I would have 4 out of 4? Interesting. Oh well. So I gotta leave the apes alive, is that the idea? God,
cunning. We will learn. Oh, yeah. I did it. Such a nice looking game. I know. Look at the backdrops. The way the landmass is like shifting ever so slightly. Oh, that's on me. I should have known the ledge would, you know, I had no much ledge to walk onto. Yeah, but I use the shoulder buttons to change what I use. Yep. Okay, cool. Yep. There we go. No! I did the same shit again. It's my bad. I only had to hit the A button. I didn't have to hit A and right. Not my fault. Oh, look. He like bonked into the wall and went backwards. That's awesome. I don't think even Prince of Persia did that. There's just so much to enjoy here. What a treat. All right. Yep. Alright, sweet. I'm saving the gun for when I need it. Yep. 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 Nice. Do I have to kiss that flag goodbye? I hope not. So here we go. I envy the kids who got this with like, oh, my grandpa bought me Planet of the Apes for Game Boy Advance. I didn't ask for this. What the fuck? Then they play it. I'm like, this is the greatest thing ever made. Sorry, buddy. Sorry. I needed that flag. They're classic apes, not the Burton design. Yeah, so maybe... Yeah, maybe... I gotta look up, what it's based on. Is it the 60s original or the Burton one? Because... Who knows? They could have smuggled this under the guise of the Burton film adaptation. But I also have a faint memory of both existing. Burton film game and original film game. Like, it's like I would say it's the 60s version. That is not Mark Wahlberg. But, like... Yeah, I'll have to confirm. YouTube review. Yeah, cool. Alright. Whoop. From 10 years ago. Hey, that's long enough. You know, this was still recent enough. I wonder what the, there's a health bar on the right. I assume that's mine. I wonder what the thing on the left is. I do wonder. Based on the 60s one? Great. Alright, cool. I must have gotten both. Hell, I should just look at my list. And that'll answer that question as well. Anyway. Okay. No, let's go under. Battling on that ledge feels precarious. And it's not like I could jump to the next one from there. Whoop! Whoop! Oh, okay. Love the tumbleweeds too. And the eagle on the cactus. Just lots of little touches that make the environment that much more interesting. From chimpanzee to chimpanzee, Juby? I'd never. Only if strictly necessary. Only whatever letters of the alphabet make themselves apparent. Oh, you didn't need to finish that. What do you take me for? I get what you're putting down. If it's Golden Age Simpsons, I get it. I do think I need to kill this guy, though. Although, what if I... Woohoo! Oh. Nope. No, I gotta do a running jump, so yes, I do have to kill that. Costume is way more iconic. Makeups and sets were good, but that's about it in the Burton one. Yeah. It's been long enough since I watched the 60s one. I'd love to watch it again, having beaten this. Fall damage, yeah, you bet. Alright, so I gotta get a run up.
Woo!
Oh. I am boning this. I gotta hit the jump button at a very late stage. Here we go. He runs by default, which is good. Yeah, did it. Sweet.
Watch 60s films. Plural, yeah, that is a plural. Every couple of years. Yeah, nice. And I take it you're not a fan of these remakes they've been doing. Or at least the newest one. It's just like, we're a franchise. I assume. Now, how am I doing for health? I'm much better now. Okay. All five. Yes. I got a knife. Don't you bother me. I've got flags. The new ones have good action choreography, otherwise I hate them. Yeah, okay. Well, it's good that you can find something to like about them. Alright. Love these illustrated panels too. That's nice. Okay. Wouldn't mind a bit of variety in the music, but that's okay. If we must. Sweet. What do you reckon, chat? Should I shotgun this guy in the face? Rhetorical question. Hey, what? Oh, I don't have ammo for it. Boo. Oh yeah, the left meter is for ammo. Okay. Well, I'm gonna shoot you in the face. Alright. Very crappy sounding gun, I'm not gonna lie. Alright, well. Potions? Monkey potion? That gun sounded like a fart. It really did. Maybe that's how they designed it, the sound effect. I don't know. Ah, health pickup. Nice. Woo! Leg. Whee! Good ladder climbing. Okay. No, I think this is ammo. Or is it? No. I don't think it is. I'm silly. Never mind. I think they're just there for scenery. Oh, damn. What's going on here? Okay. Smack. Smack. What is this? I cannot pick it up. Bees? Apparently not. Oh, there we go. Yeah, shotgun ammo. Sweet. Alright, cool. Yeah, this is nice. And yeah, as I said, now I'm like, did the GBA get any other cinematic platformers of its own? Not ports of like older games, but like platformers like this, you know? That you could find anywhere else. How cool for a random pick that we stumbled upon this. Ooh, skeleton. Hey, buddy. Let me see. Oh, yeah. Sorry. I was like wondering why you were saying that again. What's the oops part? Yeah, okay, now I get it. Oh fuck, it's a bear. Is the bear guarding something cool? I see some cool cave drawings. I can't tell, I can't see the ground. I'll somersault into it. No, hang on. Sorry, bear. I gotta see what's in here. Yeah! One flag! Woohoo! It is now. Alright. And now we're checking out Planet of the Apes for Game Boy Color. Also based on the 60s movie? I guess so. Same company, logos. Yep. Yep. You want to see the comparison? You sure can. Sticking with the Dutch. I think that's Dutch. Anyway. Yeah, Planet de Affen. So far, very similar. Different art. I like it. Yep. Yep. Going to have a nap. Alright. Okay, same basic concept. Completely different art. But yeah, this is a cinematic platformer, baby. This is cool as. Oh, hell yeah. Yeah, I could do the same shit. Now, how do I... Ooh. Yeah, I just wonder how inventory works without the shoulder buttons, that's all. But we'll figure it out. Yeah, same music. The rolls are much more impressive. Yeah, I like anything with like a decent frame rate on the Game Boy Color. There's something cool about it. And the monkeys look cool. I like them a lot. Oh, that was a cool death animation. Oh, he goes a bit slow when he's got the knife drawn. That's fun. He doesn't run. Look at that cartoon apes. Okay, and I believe that's a potion. Yeah, sweet. Almost like this more, because they just have less to work with and they still do much that... They deliver much the same game. Arguably nicer looking, you know? It's cool. Very cool. Yep, still cutting cacti. Very good. Excellent. Bit of a slow wind up on that punch, buddy. Sowie. Does the level keep going, or are there a set amount of flags? There's a set amount of flags. They look like from the Simpsons musical one? Yeah. Dr. Zegers, Dr. I mean, there are levels. Yeah, we got level over screens. If it's anything like the Game Boy Advance version, then yeah. Okay. I guess I've just missed that one. No, I haven't. I'll get it back. But first, I'm gonna kill the snake. Alright. Whoop. So cool, man. So cool. And the music loop is a little more bearable in this too. I think I prefer this one. It's just lower... We've heard a lot of Game Boy music. It can like go all out and make an absolute assault on your ears if it wants to. This is like nice and stripped back. I really like it. Just the perfect pace. I guess like the final verdict will be depending on like inventory management. Like obviously the shoulder buttons makes it very easy for Game Boy Advance. But I imagine they figured out some simple solution for this. I mean, that's it there. Like, you've got the item slots down below. It's just a question of how you access them. But I don't have more than one item, so I can't really test that. Not yet. Dr. Zeus. Dr. Zeus. Dr. Zeus. Play the piano. Anymore. But I couldn't before. Probably made by the same people who really liked the original movies, cared about making it. Yeah. Yeah, there is care in this for sure. Like, look at that. They even do the environmental details in this. There's like a little butterfly hanging out. Ugh, I wish I'd stopped and gotten that. Yeah. functions much the same. Very cool. I think it tallies how many apes I've killed. I think that's it. Man, cool as. Oh boy. You know what? I'm gonna end on a high note. I'm gonna end it there. I mean, not on the Spikefall. I mean, just the game in general, obviously. But yeah, no, look, it's been a great fucking session. I really like it. Let's turn off display capture. Let me have a look at who I may pass you on to. Thank you, everyone, for joining me. Oh, okay. Well, let's do a little two in the meantime. You're welcome, Yaz. Yeah, feast your eyes upon that in the meantime. I'm not going to be playing it, but you know. That pal Stuart. Oh well. Okay. You have a great date night as well. You keep up the quality strums also. There are all manner of things that one could strum in. GG's for sure. Yeah, as I mentioned, it'll be a whole mess of Halloween picks in a couple of days. And then on the weekend, it'll be Devil May Cry 3 for the very first time. Never played it before. Should be fun. Lots planned. See y'all later. Bye-bye.